For the most recent trends in film today is the move to smaller and lower budget films called indie films. These films tend to have plots that challenge the normal big Hollywood productions that we have become accustomed to. Many often take on topics that are more relevant to issues that we face in modern society, and the production teams are usually young and extremely innovative. But that is not to say that indie films are not customary to only lesser-known production teams. The most prominent of these high production indie films being Paul Anderson's The Master, featuring award-winning actors Philip Seymour Hoffman and Joaquin Phoenix.
Your spirit was free, moving from body to the next body. Free, free for a moment. Then it was captured by an invader force bent on turning you to the darkest way. You've been implanted with a push-pull mechanism that keeps you fearful of authority and destructive. We are in the...
However, this genre of film is not new. Indie films have been around ever since movies were first being made. And while the definition of an indie film has shifted over the course of history, the roots of what makes a film indie still stand to this day. So let's define indie, and that in itself is a complex topic. You see, indie's definition has changed throughout the years. While traditionally, indie was a term for low-budget films, it has drastically evolved into a genre that encapsulates a variety of characteristics and subgenres. Indie films are often defined by not following the traditional Hollywood narrative of capitalist American society. While indie enlists a form of filmmaking that is intended for an educated audience, one cannot simply walk into a movie theater and expect to fully comprehend the message that the director intended without deliberately seeking out to see that movie. The topics of these films also tend to hit closer to home, and often one sees that the director utilizes more pathos in their filmmaking. Indie directors are more likely to create a film that is something they feel personally passionate about rather than what corporate production companies tend to want to push. This gives directors free range when it comes to creativity and adding their own personal quirks and elements to the film.
I'm all right, thanks.
You no drink?
No. Well, Charlie.
What? Safe.
Go on, leave her.
Be back in a minute. You'll be fine. Listen.
The term independent filmmaking dates back to 1908 when big studios attempted to monopolize the film industry. Anyone who did not get bought out was considered an independent filmmaker. Due to the studios having a vast amount of expendable resources, their production quality was significantly higher than those who were deemed independent. Initially, the term indie was reserved for short, low-budget films that would sometimes include weird and quirky aspects to compensate for their lack of production quality. However, these quirks quickly became the defining feature of an indie film and set them apart from the traditional Hollywood feature films. While Charlie Chaplin was dancing around and making copy and paste comedies, Morris Engel was working on what is to be considered the first large-scale independent film ever, called Little Fugitives. This film was based on a boy who thought he accidentally killed his brother and the story of him running away from justice. The plot was far off from what Hollywood was producing in the 50s, and while it was nominated for an Academy Award, the producers and writers stated that they wanted nothing to do with the traditional Hollywood allure.
It's a very specific piece.
If we were to think about the films that were being made, there was a certain film language that was very, very distinct. Certain kinds of coverage, long shot, two shot, single, single. There was almost a formulaic way of presenting films. This film language was very strict, and in editorial terms, there were rules that one felt could not be broken.
The aesthetic that we have become accustomed to today in the indie movies is one that has a long history due to the diverse variety of subgenres within indie. What would be considered a traditional indie film is the result of the melting pot of what the indie genre is. While there is many subgenres in indie film, there is only a few that stand out the most. The French New Wave was a period in France that resulted in freedom in the industry that France had never experienced before. The French New Wave reaches farther than just France, shaping the way that Hollywood began to promote independent cinema and art tours. The movement was characterized by iconism and experimentationism. One of the most influential movies that came out of this period was Jean Luc Godard's Breathless, which came out in the 1960s. The movie embraced a rougher, more experimental personal style than is now seen throughout indie film. Grindhouse cinema is an aesthetic indie characterized by movies that came out of grindhouses. Grindhouses are independently operated theaters located in downtown or inner city areas, showcasing double and triple features of exploitation films at all hours for low admission price. These theaters showed exploitation films or films that attempted to exploit the audience by showing certain taboo or culturally unacceptable things on screen in order to draw larger crowds and increase sales. One noteworthy example of a grindhouse film is Tobe Hooper's Texas Chainsaw Massacre. This film is characterized by exploitation. The film was banned from several countries due to its unusual amount of violence. Female filmmaking is an indie subgenre that came to be characterized by films that are made by women on women. These movies stress realism, opposition to male counterparts, low budget, and complexity, which are all characteristics that have been seen in indie films today. An example of a woman filmmaking is Greta Gerwig's Lady Bird, a coming-of-age drama with a powerful female protagonist.
Why is it in quotes?
I gave it to myself. It's given to me by me.
Lady Bird always says that she lives on the wrong side of the tracks, but I always thought that was like a metaphor. But there are actual train tracks.
What she did was very baller. It was very anarchist.
Put the magazine back!
The indie film genre has taken many forms throughout the years. While the history of indie is complex, the genre has had a rebirth in the 21st century. Today, we see how the technological advancements and online streaming has provided indie filmmakers with the most artistic liberty that has ever been seen. The heyday of indie filmmaking can be seen in the early 2000s due to the affordability of filmmaking and the interest of young filmmakers to create their vision. One example of an independent in the 2000s is Michael Gondry's Eternal Sunshine of the Spotless Mind, starring Jim Carrey and Kate Winslet. This film, which tells the story of a painful breakup, was highly regarded by critics, expressing the rise of indie film.
Sorry?
I just said hi. What Howard gives to the world? To let people begin again. It's beautiful.
Completely. She's there with this guy. And she looks at me like she doesn't even know who I am.
It is through this truth that indie movies have particular characteristics. They show raw and vivid emotion, and they're not afraid of expressing the reality of what is happening in the world around us. When watching an indie movie, one isn't asked to just watch a movie. They are asked to ask questions about the world that they live in and seek to make it a better place.